Hello again. So let's talk about thoughts now. Thoughts are a normal and necessary part of meditation. The mind will naturally wander during your practice, and that's okay. Dealing with your thoughts while meditating can be a difficult thing to do, and it's important to remember that you are not trying to stop your thoughts, but rather allow them to pass through your mind without getting caught up in them. This can be a difficult task, but it's possible with practice. The most common message I get from my new students when I ask them how was the meditation is usually the same. Well, I'm not sure, but my mind is really busy. I had too many thoughts. I think too much. How can I stop thinking? And my answer is most of the time the same. You and I are humans, and we think. Our minds secret thoughts, that's what they do. This is how we are conceived, and it's part of our nature. We are not trying to stop thoughts or to control them. The only thing we want to do here is to become friends with our thoughts and have a healthy relationship. When you think, you are immersed by your thought, and you are not aware of what's happening outside of this thought. You are not aware of how you are feeling. You are not aware of the sounds around you. You don't pay attention to the people around you, and you are not aware of yourself. So how can we manage those thoughts and be aware of thinking? When you're thinking, you're not productive. It's a great thing that we can think, but we need to use it wisely. If you leave your thoughts take the lead, it will bring you nowhere than causing you stress and anxiety. It makes you nostalgic of the past and worried about the future. And we tend to be lost in them. Most of the time, they are judgmental. If you pay attention to the type of thought that you have, you will see that your body is reacting to that thought. And if you don't take the lead, you become a prisoner of your mind. So let's take a couple of examples to illustrate this. I want you to close your eyes. I want you to settle in your chair or on your sofa, depending on where you're sitting. And I want you to take a couple of deep breaths. And feel connected with the present moment. So now you can let your breath come back to a natural pace. And I want you to observe the air coming in through your nose and out from your mouth. All right, so now I want you to imagine that you want to create your own business. So first, imagine yourself how you want your business to be. Do you want to become a wedding planner, an influencer, a dancer, a surgeon, a plumber, a baker, a nurse, whatever you want to become? And I want you to see yourself as the director of your company. I want you to think of yourself, and if you have what it takes to manage this company. I want you to think of all your responsibilities. I want you to imagine how you could manage your children, if you have any, or your animals, or your relationships while directing your own company. Are you strong enough to take the lead of this company? Do you trust yourself enough? Are you worried that you will spend more time at work than at home? Are you thinking of what people will think about you? Do you think you're worth it to have your own business? So usually that's the kind of thoughts that most people have when they let their thoughts control them. We get so habituated to let our thoughts lead us, but they are not the representation of who we are and what we can or cannot do. They are only thoughts in the mind that tends to get us away from reality. If you let your thoughts guide you, it's like being in a prison. You don't get this sense of freedom. All right, so I want you now to come back to your breathing. And when you're ready, you can open your eyes and reconnect. So, I want you to pause this recording and go to the questionnaire section and tell me how was this experience and what were your thoughts? Okay, welcome back. So let's try another technique now. So just close your eyes and let your attention go within. Take a few breaths and feel connected with the present moment. I want you to imagine yourself as a dog in New York Central Park or any park, and you are observing the other dogs in the park. I want you to count all the dogs that are playing, jumping, running, or doing nothing. And after a short period of time, you will notice the thoughts that pop in, and I want you to count them. So take some deep breath. Imagine being a dog watching other dogs, and count your thoughts when they pop in. Please begin. Okay, so you can now open your eyes. So how many thoughts did you have? Under 10, 20, 30, maybe over 40? Well, actually, were your thoughts while watching the dogs? Were they body-based, like a sensation in your body, or words, sound bites, or maybe images or moving scenes? Just go to the questionnaire below and add your answer. So, what can you do with your thoughts? The first thing you can do is to journal your thoughts and bring a mindful attention to the patterns. Doing this, you're not just living in your thoughts and playing them over and over, but it's bringing them back to where they belong. Thoughts are only thoughts. This is something really important that we should realize. They are not your reality, therefore you don't have to believe your thoughts. Except if they give you compliments, that's okay, but all the other ones, we don't want them. Your thoughts are not you. They are real, like happening in your mind, inspired by the reality, but they are not true. Let's take another example. If you think of a car, you will have the image of a car in your mind, but you won't have the sensation of touching the leather, you won't hear the horn, and you won't smell the fuel. You only have the representation of the car. The problem is that most of us don't make the difference between our thoughts and reality. We make them reality. We believe what we are thinking. We believe we are what we are thinking. We believe anything that is going on in there. And that's not something that helps us on a daily basis. And by becoming mindful of your thinking, you will realize who you are beyond your thoughts. When you start your meditation, I always ask you to take a comfortable position so you can be aware of your body and any sensations in your body. And then I ask you to settle and bring your attention to your breathing, to the air coming in through your nose and out from your mouth. And I don't do this because I want you to breathe, but because focusing on your breathing brings you back to reality and what's happening now with your body. So you focus on the air coming in and out of your body and not on your mind or your thoughts. And most of the time you start thinking a little later when there are gaps in talking or actions and when your mind decides to play with you. And this is where you will focus again on your breathing to avoid being trapped in your thoughts and bring you back to your meditation. All right? So when you are thinking, you are not connected to your senses. Another thing you could do is naming your thoughts. You don't have to do it with all of them, but if you do this, you will realize that the moment you name a thought, it loses interest in your mind and then tends to go away. For example, when a thought pops in, just tell yourself, this is a thought, not the reality. And then you go back to your practice by focusing on your breathing. You could also name the type of thought. This is a stressful thought. This is a memory thought. This is a weird thought. I don't know what's happening in your mind. This is a judging thought. This is a repetitive thought, and so on. Okay? So don't try to push them away. Label them as they arise. Try to integrate an attitude of playfulness into your practice. Your practice doesn't need to be rigid and strict. There can be spontaneity and flexibility. So, your mind wanders, you see the thought, you touch it, say, here's the thought, you spend a moment with it if you want to, and then you let your thoughts pass, and then you let your thoughts pass by like clouds in the sky. For example, if you find yourself thinking about what you need to do tomorrow, simply label that thought as planning, and then you let it go. This can help you become more aware of your thoughts and let them go more easily. It's actually recognizing that thinking is happening right now. I am thinking, oh, I'm thinking of this. I'm actually thinking. Okay, but I don't need that right now. So I'm going to name or set up a type, like this is a planning thought, and then I will let it go. And maybe during my day, when I won't be mindful or meditating, and when it will come back as a memory, and then I can deal with that thought, but not for now, okay? So don't judge them. If you start judging your thoughts, then it means that you are reacting to your thoughts. And this is not what we are meant to do. We acknowledge the thought, name it in a non-judgmental way, and then we let it go and bringing back our attention to the present moment using our breathing. This is the power of mindfulness. You become friends with your thoughts and let them go. All right. So I would like to share with you this beautiful poem from Patricia Fleming called Each Moment is Precious. And I think it illustrates pretty well what I'm trying to explain here. So let's read it together. Live in the moment, just take it all in. Pay attention to everything, right there and right then. Don't let your mind wander to what's coming next. Cherish this moment and give it your best. Don't let tomorrow make you rush through today, or too many great moments will just go to waste. And the person you're with, in that moment you share, give them all of your focus. Be totally there. Laugh till it hurts. Let the tears drop. Fill up each moment with all that you've got. Don't miss the details. The lesson is there. Don't get complacent. Stay sharp and aware. It can take but a moment to change your life's path. And once it ticks by, there is no going back. In just 60 seconds, you may make a new friend, find your true love, or see a life start or end. You become who you are in those moments you live. And the growth is not in taking, but in how much you give. Life is just moments, so precious and few. Whether valued or squandered, it's all up to you. This is such a beautiful poem. I don't know what you think about. If you'd like to let me know what you think about, just use the questionnaire below or send us an email at hello@theartofwellhappiness.com. Okay, so to conclude this topic about how to manage your thoughts while meditating, you can focus on your breathing, name your thoughts, name the type of thought, be friends with your thoughts and let them go, and practice, practice, and again, practice. The more you practice, the easier it will get. Okay, so I hope this part of the course was useful for you. You can head to the quiz and questionnaire part, and I'll see you in the next section of this module. Bye for now.